by looking into the problem, you start to see solutions and design solutions, and but then also the things that you've been collecting play a real role in you know, oh, maybe I can do this like this. So I never look at these websites to see other people's work. I know the team does that, and I think it's good because you want to keep yourself in check and not repeat ideas.
You know, you create art, you're a filmmaker, you know, do you deliberately push yourself into other spaces other than design?
I always talk about how you collect ideas by looking around the world and doing things and sketching and messing about, and all of those things form almost a vocabulary of ideas that you then come to use. It stays in the sort of library of things that everyone has. And the more you see, the more you absorb, the more curious you are, the more things you have to offer, I guess. I don't think I ever call myself an artist, because I think I don't see that high quality of, I don't know, it's a different thing, isn't it? But when I came to London first to study at the Royal College of Art, it was a place that really pushed us to look at work with almost no brief and make things out of nothing and be able to imagine almost sort of really quite impossible briefs that didn't make any sense. Lockdown has been incredible for me, because even though I wouldn't lie, it's been really hard and I feel like everyone, we're exhausted, and, you know, I know you've had your share of, you know, experiencing COVID. But the one thing that has been interesting is, because you have to spend so much time in lockdown, you have to do a lot with very little. So that's where I started to do a lot more of things which have no meaning or purpose, just for pure joy, and they don't, I don't need to make any money from them.
One of the things I always try and encourage young designers to do is to not just look at design, is to like look wide and to experience wide, because those are always the best interests. And I think it even works with clients, because so often we'll have a client, say, in the insurance world, all they've done is gone and looked at all of the other insurance companies, and they're obsessed with how those insurance companies look and what they're saying and what do they have in their websites and what are they all kind of doing, and they kind of want to stay inside that. And I love this idea that things come from other things, and I always find the best or the most exciting ideas often leap categories, or they leap, you know, from a book to a design, or from a lake to a design, or from a stick to an installation. It's not, oh, I saw a really good installation, so I'm going to copy, you know, I'm going to take a similar idea and redo it over here, which I think can be quite interesting. But I think the really profound leaps is often when they come from outside of whatever discipline it is that you're working in.
Because we create habits with clients and the corporate world, especially, you start to do things in a way that resonates, and you know, the, almost get your head with the tricks, right? So it's good to break that. And Royal College for me was so life-changing, because it really made me, you know, I had an incredible mentor who was Margaret Calvert, who I still adore, and she really was, to me, quite, you know, really someone who really is about lateral thinking. And I think that starts to give you confidence to play with many more things. Things lead to other things. The more you collect and think, the more you have opportunities to make them happen. You, by looking into the problem, you start to see solutions and design solutions. And but then also the things that you've been collecting play a real role in you know, oh, maybe I can do this like this. So like you said, you don't want to look, I never look at these websites to see other people's work, because it's I know the team does that, and I think it's good because you want to keep yourself in check and not repeat ideas and stuff, but at the same time, you know, you want to think much further than that, and not, and hopefully not be influenced just by another piece of graphic design, because that feels like too close to home.
Part of that is you then get to collect that those ideas. You expose yourself to them, and then they become yours, and you get to carry them into the next project and take that insight and that inspiration into the other piece. Hello YouTube, I'm Ross Drakes. I'm the founder of Nice Work, and thank you so much for your time at watching this video. If you're seeing me, it means you made it all the way to the end, so we've at least done something right. If you enjoyed this, we'd love it if you could hit that subscribe button and that thumbs up. It really helps the channel. And I think more important than that is, if you know someone who might need to hear this, if you think someone out there who needs this message in their life, please spread the link, because it makes a huge difference to the world, and it allows us to fulfill our message of making sure that there are no more bad brands in the world. Thank you very much, and we'll catch you in the next video.